No way!
The live-action Beanie McChimp could dropkick virtual Beanie McChimp any day.
But virtual McChimp has bulletproof skin and can throw power bananas at the forces of evil.
Sorry, Gus. Computer games may be the future, but I'll take my monkey heroes live, furry, and fallible. Hey!
Who the hang is that guy?
Swinger Kid's dad?
No helmet. Better check this out. Hi, mister. Nice day for a swing, huh?
Oh, yeah. Ah, it's great to be back at good old 3rd Street Elementary.
Whoa, you went here?
Sure, back in the day. Oh, enjoy this, guys. These are some of the best times you'll ever have. The old place even smells the same.
It's the cafeteria. That stink is permanent.
You got that right, kid. Well, I gotta go. Take her easy, guys.
You too, mister.
Name's Dudikoff. Frank Dudikoff.
Did you say Dudikoff?
Ah, same old bell, too. Later.
Boy, for a grown-up, he sure was nice.
Nice. Guys, that dude was the dude.
The dude?
Of course, I should have known. The great Franklin Dudikoff.
I'm getting goosebumps.
We're not worthy, man.
I don't need to sound behind the times, but who is this dude guy anyway?
Follow me, Gus, and I'll show you. Legend has it, the dude did that.
Bigfoot Finster was here.
A classic crack-up.
A stunt like that could get you crowned Prankster Prince.
He was that, Gus, and so much more. He was the coolest kid to ever play this hollow grass. He's my idol, my inspiration, my guiding light.
They say he ascended to the king's throne at the semi-tender age of 8, the only 3rd grader ever to do so.
I hear he led the great cafeteria revolt against something they used to call the Tuesday Surprise.
Best of all, the dude ran rings around Finster pulling prank after prank on her, like this beauty right here.
There's a word I've heard reserved for a special few. Moxie.
Yep, the grown man we met at the swings is a living, breathing legend.
Wow!
And I shook his hand. Still tingling. I only wish I could have asked the dude some questions.
Yeah, I'd like to know where he got that giant shoe.
Sorry I'm late, class, but I was greeting your new student teacher. Please give a warm hello to Mr. Dudikoff.
Dudikoff?
Whoa, that must be the dude. Mr. Dudikoff will be with us for a few weeks, learning how to help you learn by learning, while I quietly observe from the back. I now hand the keys to your young minds over to Mr. Dudikoff. Good luck, Franklin, and don't feel nervous that your entire teaching career depends on how you do in these next 2 weeks.
I won't. Miss Scrotke tells me you're about to study the shocking field of electricity. And so I brought some materials to, Theodore?
First of all, let me just say I'm a huge fan. Gigantic. And I just want to say, welcome back, dude.
Well, thank you. But please call me Mr. Dudikoff. The dude never really belonged in the classroom.
Gotcha, Mr. Dudikoff.
Now, where did I put that science text? Oh, yes, here it is. Electricity, part 1. All matter is composed of atoms. Atoms, in turn, are composed of subatomic particles, protons, neutrons, and electrons.
Both. Gee, what's this junk got to do with electricity?
Shh, the dude is talking.
Thought of as the atom's core. Part 5. Static electricity. Static electricity is the type of electricity created when a balloon-type object, A, is rubbed vigorously against a wool-type object, B.
What you talking about, dude?
Mr. Dudikoff, could I talk to you for a second?
Yes, ma'am.
It's occurred to me, Franklin, that maybe my being here is making you a tad nervous.
Oh, no, Miss Grokey. Well, maybe just a little. But it is my first day, and...
How about if I go take care of a few things in the office? You just stay here and keep on teaching. Okay, kids, I leave you in Mr. Dudikoff's sweaty but capable hands.
Oh, boy. Flying solo. Okay, where were we? Because there is no quick way for the electrons to leave object A.
Face it, teach. Your dude's a dud.
Maybe the dude just needs a little prompting. Mr. Dudikoff, I got a question.
Okay, Theodore, I'll try and clear up whatever it is you don't understand.
What was it like being the only 3rd grader in history to ever be king of the playground?
See, that's not in the lesson plan for today.
And tell us how you led the great cafeteria revolt. You know, they're still picking dried noodles off stuff.
Now that'd be worth writing down.
Come on.
Yeah, come on.
Kids, Miss Grokey is expecting me to teach you about electricity and... Hey, maybe a diagram will help.
And what about Miss Finster?
Did you say Finster?
He's a washout, isn't he?
Oh, Muriel, I'm not sure I know what you're talking about.
That Dudikoff kid can't be any good.
No, he's fine. He just needs to find his inner teacher.
A boy like that will never be a teacher. He's a bad apple, Grokey, and bad apples never ripen.
Well, this apple did, Muriel. Come with me and you'll see for yourself.
And that's when...